For the latest, we are joined once again tonight via Skype from Jerusalem by Josef Federman of the Associated Press. Josef, your story today was about the people that were fleeing Gaza.
Yes, overnight, Israel sent out warning leaflets. They dropped them out of the sky, telling people in the northern Gaza Strip to clear out. Israel is planning heavy bombardment. We've seen a few airstrikes this evening already. In the meantime, somewhere between 15 and 20,000 people, residents of that area, have cleared out. They're on their way to shelters in UN schools in safer areas of Gaza.
We'd heard about the commando raid operation inside Gaza, but we'd also heard that there was a police chief's house that was bombed.
Yes, these were two separate incidents. The commando raid took place overnight. It's the first time that Israel has sent ground forces into Gaza. It was a very brief pinpoint type operation. They went after, or they say they went after, a rocket launching site that couldn't be reached through aerial attacks. So they sent in a small team of naval commandos, and they were in and out. There were some light injuries, actually, on the Israeli side. As for the police chief, there was an airstrike last night. This was considered a senior target by Israel. He is the Hamas police chief of Gaza. The airstrike hit the home where he was staying. 17 members of the man's family were killed, but the police chief, as of now, is still alive.
What about on the diplomatic front? Any news, any progress?
There seems to be a lot of movement behind the scenes. It's very hard to figure out what exactly is going on. Secretary of State John Kerry, who's in Vienna, meeting with many of his Western counterparts right now, called the Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu today, expressed his concerns about the escalating tensions, and said that he's been in touch with some of the key players in the region. So the U.S. is involved in the behind-the-scenes efforts. Other members are also involved. Egypt put out a statement. They're in touch with the U.N. Secretary General. Other players, ranging from Qatar to Turkey, even France, Tunisia, they're all involved. It's hard to figure out what exactly is going on. A lot of people are involved.
All right. Josef Federman of the Associated Press joining us via Skype from Jerusalem. Thanks so much.
Thank you.